Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Francis of Assisi Parish and the celebration of the life of Ileana Mele. At this point in time, we'd like to invite Aaron to come forward to share some words.
Thank you, everyone, for joining us today to celebrate the life of Ileana Mele, or as us lucky grandkids and great-grandkids like to call her, Noniana, or just Noni. Ileana was born on November 13, 1933, on the northern side of the Mediterranean in a place called Trieste, a seaport city. Italy entered the war when she was 6 years old. She had to grow up fast to be tough and bold. One night she went out dancing with one of her friends. The bouncer at the door asked, "Where's your husband?" "What husband?" she exclaimed. "And even if I had one, what would that matter? No man is telling me what I can or can't do." She told him that she didn't like Italian boys when he asked her to dance. "Well, I'm not actually Italian, I'm American," he replied. So she gave him a chance. They decided to get married and things were soon underway, moving across the Atlantic to start a new life with Joseph Mele in the USA. They moved around a bit while Joe was in the army, and while traveling overseas, they had a daughter named Gail, born in Germany. They settled down finally one day in a town in New Jersey called Bradley Beach. Ileana worked nights in the ICU to make extra cash and to make ends meet. Of course, she still loved to go dancing. It's one of her favorite pastimes, as long as she could refresh herself with some beer or some wine. Two grandkids came, Allison and Aaron, which changed things up a bit. Then shortly after, Ileana found herself moving south to Virginia. That's where she found her church, her friends, and her community. Two more grandkids came, Rebecca and Rachel, and now she's got her hands full. And honestly, she spoiled us a lot, which was awesome. Another two great grandkids, Sean and Kellen, who she loves more than anything. She, of course, has a huge family in Italy and extended family in New Jersey. And I know some have moved around a bit, but there are too many people to name. And I say this for the simple fact that Ileana thought family is really important, the most important thing, and we're all really going to miss her. Holidays were also really important to Ileana, and she loved to go all out every chance she could. Easter baskets, stockings full of chocolate and Nutella at Christmas, along with the massive mountain of presents, American flags everywhere on the 4th of July. Decorations filled the yard when we were kids because her and my grandfather always wanted the yard to be lit up for us when we came over. She loved to volunteer with the church and was always excited to bring us along to help. And whenever we came to visit, she would cook a big dinner for the two of us, and she would always make me take all the leftovers home so I had something to eat all week. And the last few times I saw her, she was dumping a bunch of information on me for things that were really important and she needed me to know. She told me about one of her most prized possessions and asked me to keep it always. She asked to make sure that Big Boy, her cat, was taken care of. But there was something so important that she brought it up on two different occasions, just to make sure I wouldn't forget. In the kitchen and in the back bedroom, there was a big stash of chocolate bars and salamis that she wanted to make sure that I got before they went bad. Because that's who she was. And she was my Noni. Thank you.
Please stand and join in singing our gathering song, Be Not Afraid, number 438 in the Breaking Bread hymnal.
You shall speak. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And may the grace and the comfort and the peace of God our Father and of the Lord Jesus Christ be with each one of you. And in the waters of baptism, Ileana died with Christ and rose with him to new life. And may she now share with him eternal glory. We gather together here at St. Francis's Church with Ileana's family, her parish family, to give thanks to God for her life. Ileana was often here sitting in the front pew to worship and to pray with us, and we know that now she is in the loving hands of God. So let us bow our heads in prayer. O God, who have set a limit to the present life so as to open to us entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may commend the name of your servant Ileana to be described in the book of life. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now to listen to the word of God.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. As sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Our responsorial psalm is As the Deer Longs, number 778 in the Breaking Bread hymnal.
As the deer longs for running streams, so I
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. We are here today because Ileana's earthly pilgrimage has now come to an end, and she is in her eternal dwelling place in heaven. Just a few short months ago, Ileana was here for the daily Mass, and she was sitting in her usual place right over there. And the Eucharistic prayer that I use had these words where we're praying for those who have died, but then we also pray for ourselves. And as I say this prayer where God is speaking to us, I always like to look around at all of those who are here whereas we're praying. And I looked at Ileana, and in this prayer we say, "Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever." And the words of that prayer really describe the story of all of us, that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that God has an eternal dwelling place with us in heaven. And those words of that prayer are now Ileana's prayer in her life, because her earthly pilgrimage, her long and rich earthly pilgrimage, has come to an end, and she is now in God's presence, in God's loving hands. Now, I only got to know Ileana for the last 3 years that I was here, but as I look at her picture and then as I hear Aaron with the eulogy, I could recognize some of those characteristics that I even knew just these last 3 years. You know, Aaron described her as a woman who is fast, who is tough and bold. She's a woman of faith and tenacity, really. And I could really see that in her these last few years here. When she came to Mass, you know, she got here. Oftentimes she drove herself coming here to Mass. I remember last year at our parish picnic, Father John O'Connor was then pastor, and I said to him, you know, I think Ileana is still driving. He said, oh, no, she's not driving. But we all know she was still driving, right? Because she's fast and tough. And as we heard in the eulogy, no man is going to tell her what to do. But her faith in her parish community was important, even more her family was, but her parish community was also very important to her. And I remember how impressed I was when, first of all, her own slow but determined pace to get here for Mass and to get up to her front here for Mass. But the other thing that impressed me was how the different people in the community would always reach out to help her and to make sure that she was okay, would help her to come up or to go back from communion. And as I saw that, it always struck me the words of Jesus at the Last Supper, where he first of all gets on his knees and washes the feet of his disciple. And he says, and what I've done is an example, so you also must do. And so as the different people, and as Aaron was helping her towards the end, those were all different ways of following Jesus' example. But also, I think the other challenge of that, what Jesus was doing, is to allow people to help us. And Ileana did that. Jesus wants us not only to wash the feet of one another, but to allow other people to help us and to wash our feet and to allow our feet to be washed. And so Jesus gives us that example, and then he says in his prayer at the Last Supper, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith and you have trust in God, and you have faith and trust in me. And so as we look over Ileana's long and rich life, we can see that she had that faith and that trust in God. And when Jesus is saying, don't let your hearts be troubled, he's not saying there's no room for tears, or there's no room for questions, or there's no room for doubts. But what Jesus is saying, that in the midst of those questions, in the midst of that emptiness and that loss, those doubts and those tears, Jesus is saying that God is right here beside you. In the Gospel of John elsewhere, we hear what I think is perhaps the most important words of any words in the Gospel. It's a simple phrase, and Jesus wept. He wept because his good friend Lazarus had died. And I think that phrase is so important because, first of all, it shows us the humanity of Jesus, doesn't it? You and I, we weep when we lose someone who is close to us. Sometimes we hold down the tears, but at some point, those tears come out. And so it's very human for us to weep. But even more, I think, in Jesus weeping, he shows us his divinity. That God is a God of compassion. That God, this morning, is with you. That God shows his compassion, and God is even weeping with you as you mourn and as we mourn this loss of Ileana. But it's through those tears and through that emptiness that God also wants us to know that Ileana is in the hands of God. As Jesus says to the apostles, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I show you the one true God, and I show you the way to God the Father. For as Paul says, those who have died in Christ will also rise with Christ. For Paul, the ultimate answer to the mystery of death is the love of God. Paul in Romans writes that there's nothing that can ever separate us from the love of God. And I also think that's important for us to not only hear but to feel, because sometimes you and I, we think we can shut God off. We think we can sort of divorce ourselves from God. And yet what Paul is saying there, no, but God's love is so powerful, even more powerful than a mother or a father, that there is nothing that can ever separate us from that love of God. And so Paul says to us, as we look at the unknown, as we look at the mystery of death, the answer and really our faith is the love of God overcomes even the mystery, the chasm of death. And it's that faith that tells us that Ileana is now in the loving hands of God. At the end of our liturgy this afternoon, we have the prayer that's called the prayer of commendation. As we heard in the first reading from the Book of Wisdom, the souls of the just are in the hands of God. And in that prayer of commendation, we commend Ileana to the loving hands of God. And the imagery there in the prayer is the prayer of a parent, of a mother bending down to lift up her child. And in that prayer, Ileana, who has lived and finished her earthly pilgrimage, she comes to her new and eternal home. And as we commend her to the loving hands of God, God has bent down as a loving father and lifts her up to her new and to her heavenly home. Let us stand now for our prayer of the faithful. My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Ileana received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Our sister Ileana was nourished at the table of the Lord. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Our sister spent her life following Jesus, poor, chaste, and obedient. Count her among all the holy ones who sing in your court. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families here have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. The family and friends of Ileana seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord. Loving and merciful God, it is in confidence and in trust we place our prayers and our needs before you, and we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Please be seated as our gifts are being prepared.
Our offertory song is Here I Am, Lord, number 395 in the Breaking Bread hymnal.
Thank you.
Please stand. My sisters and brothers, please join with me now in praying that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Ileana, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Please kneel. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once he did for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scripture and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Therefore, O Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to a perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, with all the bishops and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us in words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Stand. Filled with the Holy Spirit, we pray now to our Heavenly Father in the words that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I leave you always. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with each one of you. Amen. Let us offer to one another a sign of peace. Thank you. Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. There'll be two ministers up front here for communion. When you come up, if you don't wish to receive, but just to receive a blessing, if you would just cross your arms like this, and one of the ministers will give you a blessing.
Communion song is Age to Age, number 510 in the Breaking Bread hymnal.
Only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Let us stand to conclude our prayer. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Ileana may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Ileana, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. To your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Ileana, in the sure and the certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now go forth in peace. Thanks be to God.
The family invites all to join them after the service across the way at the school for coffee, tea, lemonade, and sweet delights. Thank you. Our closing song is Canticle of the Sun, number 429 in the Breaking Bread hymnal.